Hello, I'm Reverend Sam, and this is Power Encounter TV broadcast. I thank God I'm able to come your way today, and I therefore pray that in the name of Jesus, the power of the Most High God will flow through me to you, through my word to you, because the word of God is full of life and power. I pray you will receive deliverance as you hear the word of God today. You will receive liberation as you hear God's words today, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am still continuing on exploring the healing power of the church. Because the truth of the matter is that you and I, we are the church. The place where we meet is simply the meeting place for the church of Jesus Christ. In other words, that particular hall where we meet, if we don't meet there in the name of the Lord, some other people can meet there in the name of Satan. So we are the body of Christ. And the healing power that God has given to us is given to the church. And that church includes you and me. All of us. It doesn't mean that it's only your own church that there are only people of God. There are people of God in every church. The Lord Jesus has his own people in every congregation and every assembly. And that's why I believe that God is sending me to you today. Now, I want us to check this scripture today, the book of Mark chapter 16. In Mark chapter 16, Jesus was giving his disciples his valedictory speech when he was about to go. He was speaking to them certain things. And he said in verse 17 and verse 18, from verse 15, he was talking about the fact that they should go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation. And that anyone that believes will be saved, and those who do not believe will be condemned. And then in verse 17, he says, and this sign shall follow those who believe. And I believe, if you have given your life to Christ, you are one of the believers that Jesus is talking about. He said, in my name, they shall cast out demons. In my name, they shall speak with new tongues. In my name, they shall take up serpents with their hands. In my name, if they drink any deadly poison, it will not hurt them. And now where I am going. He said, in my name, they will lay hands on the sick, and the sick will recover. Listen, it's not just the pastors of the church that have been given the authority to lay hands on the sick, and the sick will recover. That reminds me of many years ago, almost 30 years ago, after I gave my life to Jesus. The place where we stayed at that time, the house where we stayed, back in Africa, is Face Me, I Face You house and all that. And then over 80% of the women, both married women, young ladies in that house at that time, belonged to, the Obanje cult. When I came back from school, they know that I am the light. They know there's something different, but because they attacked me in my dreams and they were not able to overcome. But one particular day, I was cooking. And the kitchen is normally at the back, at the back of the house. So I was cooking rice and I put the food on the stove and I went inside. And then I went to go get salt. And by the time I came back, I put salt in the food. And then I had this voice in my spirit, your food is poisoned. And I'm like, who can poison my food? This is like 9:30 in the morning. He said that food is poisoned. Now, I didn't take that voice seriously. So after the food is done, I served it and I started eating. But as soon as I ate the first, second, and third spoon, I started having this running stomach and all my system became disorganized. I began to sweat profusely. I was feeling, I don't know how to explain. Then I remember that I heard that food was poisoned. And then I remember this scripture that if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. Now, as a believer then, I was not a pastor. So I put my hand in my tummy and I said, all you poison in my system, oh yeah, in the name of Jesus, I command you to be nullified. Whatever poison that the enemy put in the food, Lord, I command that poison to be nullified right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, because that poison is nullified. The power to poison me is destroyed in Jesus' name. And then after I said that, like 10 seconds and everything went down. And then anytime I say that, people said, ha. And then I continue to eat the same food. Somebody said, man of God, why don't you put the food away? I've already destroyed the poison. And then in those days, my brother, poverty was at the door. If I throw that food away, I'm going to be hungry the whole day. So I had the food. Now, but what am I trying to say? There is power inherent in you. The Bible says, God is able to do more than what we ask or think according to the power that's at work in us. There's a part of God that is working in your life. And what I'm saying is that part of the manifestation of that power is the healing grace. You can lay hands upon the sick and the sick will recover. I remember one time that Pastor Adebo was talking about how he developed his healing grace. He said when his children were still very young, he said one of his children was very, very sick. And he said he went to go and buy anti-malaria drug and gave the boy. And then he also put anointing oil at one side. He said he went to go and buy anti-malaria drug and put it on the table. And then he laid the hands upon the boy and prayed for the boy. With the mind that if the anointing did not heal the boy, he will use the medicine. But the anointing in his hand healed the boy. He said that was how he started developing his healing anointing. You are watching me right now. You also can begin to do the same. You know the way I started my own. Anytime I have a problem with myself, I will just lay hand upon myself and begin to pray. Because the Bible says, you shall lay hands upon the sick. I said, Lord, I am sick. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke the spirit of sickness and disease. That is how I began to develop my healing grace. And you, as a child of God, has the same grace. Listen, look for people around you that are sick and begin to pray for them. Don't be afraid. Hey, what about if they are not healed? You are doubting. The Bible says that anyone that doubts is like the wave of the sea. That person should not think that he will receive anything from the Lord, because he's unstable in all his ways. Just believe that because the word of God says you will lay hands upon the sick and the sick will recover. Place your hand and pray. Believe God for healing. And very soon, you'll be surprised that people will start coming to church to come and give testimony. And then you will be happy that God is using you. But apart from that, you are also beginning to develop the grace of God in your life. One of the gifts that we have as a church is to lay hands upon one another and pray for one another. And so the question I want to ask you is, when was the last time you prayed for somebody that is sick in your church? What we do is that we wish them evil. You see a member that is going through trouble. Maybe they are sick, and then deep down inside you, God has caught him. You think he's the only spiritual person in this church. No, that is the spirit of Satan that is manifesting through you. We are supposed to be compassionate one to another. Jesus said, by this shall all men know that you are my disciples, if you have love one for another. We are supposed to show love one for another. Even if the brother or the sister has offended you, listen, it's more or less like as a parent. If your child has offended you and the child develops sickness, are you going to leave the child to die? No. You will look for healing medicine for the child. You will take care of the child, even if you are going to discipline the child for the mistake he or she has committed. It's the same thing with God. God is not a wicked God. Don't say, no. Man of God, you don't understand. This sickness is on me because God is trying to discipline me. No. Sickness is not from God. Satan is the author of sickness. And that's why, as a member of the church, you have been given the power to heal the sick. How can God give you power to heal sickness if he is the one that brings sickness? That means he's giving you power to undo his work. God does not disorganize himself. So my point is this, my dear people. As a church, we have power to pray for one another's healing. And when we begin to use it, we'll begin to spend less money on drugs. We'll begin to spend less money on medicine. More people begin to give testimony of God's sovereign power to heal. And you know what testimony does? Testimony attracts unbelievers to come to church. People start saying, when you go to that fellowship, if you are sick in your body, by the time they pray for you, you'll be healed. Then they'll still start saying that church, it's only that church, if you go there, no matter the sickness, as you are there, they are praying for you, you'll be healed. Now, you see, one of the ways we can advertise the gospel to the unbelievers is by using the healing grace. The Bible says Philip went to Samaria and was preaching Christ. And people were coming because they were hearing the gospel and they were seeing the miracles he was doing. It's time for you and I to begin to stand up and become who we have been made to be. Healers of our generation. Listen, the devil has poisoned this generation. Many people are not sick physically, but they are sick emotionally, and they need the word of healing from your mouth. The Bible says he sent this word and he led them and delivered them from their destruction. How can God send this word? He has told us. He said, go into the world. Preach the gospel. Share the gospel with them. And heal those who are sick. Not just physical sickness. Sometimes emotional sickness. Marital sickness. Financial sickness. Professional sickness. They don't know what to do. They are downcast. Your word can become the healing balm. And that's what the Lord wants me to tell you today. That just as you are, take up that challenge. Let us begin to work together as the body of Christ to make the church of God a formidable team, a mighty man of war, so that together we can stand against the opposition that comes from the kingdom of darkness. And let me tell you this, when you begin to pray for other people's healing, you are also maturing, because the only mature people care for others. Children only care for themselves. Only people that are maturing take time to care for other people. And one of the main reasons why God put apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers in the church is for the maturing of the saints. I am doing my part right now to open up your heart and let you know that you can begin to activate the power of healing that is inside you. You say, man of God, even me, I'm ravaging with sickness. Yes, the reason is because of your ignorance. There is no way a pipe we transport water and remain dry. If the Lord has given you the grace to heal other people, guess what? The healing power is in you. You may not have believed it, you may not have known until now, or you may not have been putting it to use, but it's there. And it's time for you to start taking charge. I therefore pray for you today. I connect with the grace of God on my life. I connect it to your spirit. I activate your spirit to receive the healing grace in the name of Jesus. Everyone that is sick, I rebuke the spirit of sickness. I rebuke the spirit of disease. I command right now that every pain will leave you in the name of Jesus Christ. Even that report from the doctors, that is man's report. Whose report will you believe? Listen to me. The Bible says that Jesus came so that you can be set free. He gave himself so that you can be delivered from the oppression of darkness. By his stripes, you were healed. I take that report from your hand, because somebody has a paper that your doctor gave you, I can see it. I tear it by faith in the name of Jesus, and I hand over to you the report of the Lord, which said that you shall not die but live to declare the goodness of God. And I decree that this day you will live to declare the goodness of God in the name of Jesus. Someone is watching me. It's more or less that bad news follows you. Unfortunate things follow you. I deliver you today in the name of Jesus Christ. By the authority of Christ, I set you loose. I set you loose. I break you loose in the name of Jesus. And I give you the anointing for rest. Receive refreshing. You that is trouble-hearted. Yes, yes, yes. I command that spirit of anxiety to leave you now in Jesus' name. Receive rest by the power of God. In Jesus' mighty name, from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, be made whole completely. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen, and amen. Let me know what God has done in your life. Send us a mail, send us a text message. And if you want us to pray together, just send me a mail, send us a text message, I will get back to you. And if you are really serious about it, we will agree together, and then we will take advantage of the power that God has given to us as his body, and then stop the work of the darkness and glorify God in your life. And if you love to pray, or you just love the anointing of God upon my life, there's a prayer network that God has instructed me to start. It's called Refiner's Fire Prayer Network. It's a prayer network where we all come together to pray. It's once in a month, it's on a Saturday, but you've got to send me your name and your phone number so that we can send you the address of where we're going to do the next one that's coming up in by this month, by the grace of God. I've got to go right now because time is not on my side. I'd like to hear from you. And until I hear from you, until we see again, I want you to know that no matter what you have gone through in life, now that you're a child of God, something is very sure. You are wonderful because Jesus is real. I'll see you next time. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Lord, you are great. Thunder announce your presence. The storm announce your power. I can't imagine your greatness.